Hi there, everybody. Today we're going to have a look at yet another easy way to optimize your game. Just like the draw text video, these tips will also have the potential to double or triple your frame rate. If you're drawing text in your games, I recommend you watch that video as well. But now, let's have a look at how to improve your game using texture groups to avoid texture swapping. GameMaker don't handle all your game art as individual small images. Instead, GameMaker places them all on one or more texture pages and just crops out the parts that's not needed for your asset at runtime. This may sound complicated, and it is, but GameMaker handles it for you. Most game engine uses texture pages to improve performance and memory usage. While this is very smart, you may experience loss in performance once you have more art than fits into one of your texture pages. Some targets do not support texture pages larger than 2048 by 2048. Then GameMaker must switch between the texture pages to draw your room, and that's what's called texture swapping. GameMaker then have to load the pages in and out of memory. Some swapping is no problem, but if you're drawing images from multiple texture pages without any consideration, it will result in loss of performance. Let's have a look at one example. In this room, I placed multiple of these small squares, a total of about 192 objects. They did not have any code, just the sprites. But the most important thing to know is that the blue and the green sprites are placed in two different texture groups. Let's run the simple game and have a look at the frame rates. Okay, as you can see, the frame rate is now about 1200 frames per second, somewhere around there at least. And that's when just displaying these objects and sprites. So let's see now. If we go back and go to Tools, Texture Groups, and I'll look. I created two texture groups. The one is colors, and the other one is greens. Replace the green sprites. The color is the rest of them. So let's now place sprite 4 alongside the green ones on the same texture. Let's now add in the blue one alongside the green ones. And rerun the game. Now we got a frame rate at about 5,000, 4,500, yeah, average about close to about 5,000 frames per second. And now it's actually up to 5,000, 6,000 frames per second. So just by grouping the sprites, we have improved the performance a lot. It's therefore important when you build your game that you group your sprites the best way for your game. That's often by grouping them by what's in a room or on a level. But if you for some reason are stuck having multiple texture pages and important elements spread on both that goes into the same level, I'm going to show you another tip for how you can still improve your game. Now, the idea is that I create a new object that will handle the drawing of the first object. So in new object, I have a draw event where I have the code with object 4. That's the blue one. Just tells all the objects to draw themselves, but together. So they're doing it batched. And I do the same with object 5. With all of them, draw themselves. And now, because now we're handling the drawing in object 7 here, let's turn it off on the actual objects themselves. So now they're no longer visible. Oh, and of course, let's remove the blue sprite from the greens again, from the texture group. Like so. Now the blue one, object 4, is back in the colors group. And in the greens, we only have the greens. And then in your room, drag in the newly created object, object 7, in this case. And let's run that room. And now we got an average frame rate at about around 5,000 frames or 4,500 frames. Jumping a bit around here, but still, this also helps. But this is only most effectful for objects that's going to be placed multiple times on a level or in a room. It's not good as of having them all on one texture page or in a texture group, but it still improves performance a lot. I hope these tips help. And if you're interested in more, please leave a comment. And also, do remember to subscribe.